You'll find all the types of shapes on the Insert tab in the ribbon menu. Charts and pivot tables are types of objects that can be manipulated like any other objects, and so is smart art and word art, but by far the most common types of objects are pictures and shapes. Now, pictures could come from Microsoft's predefined collection of clip art, but unlike Visio, it's extremely easy to add your own custom shapes by simply clicking the picture button and then inserting any picture that you want. It's that easy to maybe supplement some of our standard stick figures with some of your own, or transportation shapes, or information flow shapes that might be unique to your type of business. And you can take a screenshot of any portion of any screen and convert it into a picture that can be used within Excel. As easy as that. Pretty useful, isn't it? Now, unlike pictures, you have to choose from the predefined palette of shapes. It's not easy to define your own custom shapes, but they're even more useful than pictures because you can rescale them to any size without losing resolution. And you can so easily format them for different colors, line thicknesses, fonts, and other artistic effects. And by the way, a text box is just a unique type of shape. You're going to love shapes. Lines and arrows are a special type of shape. If a line is not connected to anything, it has a white end, and if it is connected, it'll have a red end. Once connected, the line will stay with the shape even when it is moved. And you can even grab hold of these little yellow diamond handlebars to move your line around other objects. But don't overuse those yellow diamonds because those lines will sometimes reset back to their own default shape on their own. Now, in your layout diagram template, Systems to Win purposefully replaced these red walk path arrows so that they don't connect, because that particular type of arrow is not supposed to be connected. And the final type of object is a group. If you group several shapes together, they will be treated as one object. Now, in addition to the standard shapes that come with Excel, many Systems to Win templates come with a palette of unique shapes that are specifically designed for that continuous improvement tool. And notice that many of the Systems to Win shapes are actually a group consisting of both a picture and an auto shape, thereby making them far more useful. And unlike standard Excel shapes, you can get help for any Systems to Win picture or shape by right-clicking it and selecting Size and Properties. And there in the Alt text, you will find a description of what that shape is, and perhaps even a link to additional training so you can learn more about that. And if we select the Systems to Win tab in the Excel ribbon bar and select Copy Shapes, that will open up this palette of shapes that can be copied into any Excel document, not just a Systems to Win template, but any Excel document, which helps you to standardize the way that you communicate. Most commonly, you will copy a lightning burst to indicate that there's a problem, and a fluffy cloud when someone comes up with a great idea for how to solve that problem. So let's do it. Let's select a lightning burst and then Control C to copy it, and then move to our target document and Control V to paste it. Then edit the text to explain our problem. Then maybe click back to our copy shapes document that's already open in the background to maybe select this arrow that we also want to copy and paste into our block diagram to point to exactly where the problem is. And then maybe go back to copy another shape because maybe we want to circle the problem. So we copy the circle, paste it into our document. Then we right-click it, send it to the back. And if you want to change the color, you know how to do it. Right-click it, Format Shape, and change the line color. When you learn how to draw in Excel, you know how to draw in PowerPoint. You know how to draw in Word. You have no idea how to draw in Visio. And if you scroll down, you will find this section for user-defined shapes where your leaders can optionally add your own shapes. Perhaps logos for your different divisions, or perhaps your own hazardous material shapes unique to your industry. And remember, these shapes are always available in any Excel document, not just a Systems to Win template, because that Systems to Win tab is still there. So your palette of your unique shapes is always available to every Excel user. And notice that teensy-weensy little connector diamond. That has a very special purpose. You can group that tiny little connector diamond with any other shape to create unlimited connection points anywhere on any shape. And from the Systems to Win menu, if you select the Insert Link icon menu item, that opens up a palette of special shapes for linking to different types of related documents. And a palette of flag icons that you can use for linking to documents in different languages. When someone sees their flag, they know they're going to be able to read that when they follow that link. And these link icons are available in any Excel or Word document. So your people will get real used to seeing these as a standardized and very visual way to link to any related document. And unlike any standard 16-pixel shapes you download off the internet, we had to create all these shapes to be specially sized and formatted so that when you hide, they hide. And when you unhide, they unhide. And when you change the height of a row, they don't do that. Now, the final subject that we will discuss in this video is not just one type of object, but I want them all. In other words, let's say that I want to copy this section of this root cause map into a PowerPoint slide. So I select the cells that I want to copy, Control C to copy them, then go over to my blank PowerPoint slide and Control V to copy. And yikes, what an unusable mess. So what's the right way to do it? After selecting my cells in Excel, I select the drop-down list for this copy as picture. And leave those radio buttons at their defaults for as shown on screen and format picture. Then click OK. And it's best to delete anything that's in the PowerPoint so that you've got a blank slide to copy into. And then simply paste into the blank slide. Now you've got a clean, usable picture that you can optionally resize or treat like any other picture. And of course, I could have pasted into any type of document, not just PowerPoint. Could have been another Excel document, Word document, Visio document, doesn't matter. So now you know the right way to copy as picture. We know you work hard. And here at Systems to Win, we're doing everything we can to make your continuous improvement tools as easy to use as possible so that you can get home to what you'd rather be doing.